say that I'm very happy to live in a society where I don't have to use my gender, the fact that I'm white, or that I'm oppressed, or anything like that, to garner and gain what I feel I'm entitled to. No, in fact, I live in a society where that is actually earned through hard work and dedication, not given. I mean, let's be honest. You go up to a straight white man, and the two of you are talking, and the two of you keep talking, and the two of you keep talking. Never once in the entire conversation that you can have with any straight white man will he ever bring up the fact that he's white, or that he's straight, or that he is cisgendered, and that you need to listen to him first, and that's the reason why he should speak first. Never have I heard anything like that. However, in today's society, we are now living in a world where if you're not white, if you're not straight, and if you're not cis, then you're automatically oppressed in every way, shape, and form, and thus need to be addressed with immediately and have the platform to speak up at. I can go outside right now, have a conversation with my neighbor about irrelevant stuff to anything political or anything gaming, anything newsworthy, just talking about my family in general, see how their family is doing. And never once will I hear them tell me to shut up because they're black, they have the right to speak. Never once will I hear them tell me to shut up because they're Hispanic and they have the right to speak due to oppression points. The only time I ever hear anything about because I'm a woman or because you're a woman is the fact that men cannot hit women. I grew up hearing that. Not from my family, mind you, because my family was, if my brother hit me, I expect him to hit, you know, if I hit him, I expect him to hit me back. If he struck me, he expects me to hit him back. You know, that's equality right there. Never once has he ever been told that he cannot hit me because I am a woman. Never once has he ever been told that he cannot hit my sister because she is a woman or because we're girls. That is the type of society that we live in. Men cannot hit women because they're women. Literally, that's it. That is the only excuse they have. Sure, it was a chivalrous thing in the past because women were pregnant, would be the bearers of the children and take care of the household and stuff and so on and so forth, while the men fought in their wars and had their and did their business and work and so on and so forth. However, and this is the however, I would never hear from my family that my brother cannot hit me because I'm a woman. It would just be, don't hit your sister. Or it would be, don't hit your brother, from my family. And then to further this, every time I see these people protesting and arguing and complaining and bitching and yelling and screaming and throwing a huge ass tantrum in the middle of the goddamn highway, every fucking time I see this, the very first thing that I happen to catch in here for some strange reason is, shut up, I'm black. Shut up, I'm a woman. Shut up, I'm lesbian. Shut up, I'm transgendered. Like, literally, you feel that you're so entitled to speak that you have to tell everyone else around you to shut up because of your special qualifications. And I'm going to air quote special qualifications because that is literally what I'm doing right now. You can't see that, unfortunately. But that is what I hear in these protests. That is what I hear in these arguments. You know, shut up, you're white. Shut up, you're a man. Shut up, you're cis. Okay, and why exactly are you telling them to shut up? Because you want to speak? Okay, fine, you speak. And then you let him speak and you let him listen to you. As he listens to you, you listen to him. If you don't want to listen to him, then you need to shut up and leave. It is a two-way street. If you refuse to listen to the other side of the argument, then you have no stance to argue against to begin with. Refusing to listen in a debate is automatic disqualification for you as a person. You need to understand, or at least listen to the other side of the story. Something that I think only Lacey Green has so far done so. So, as well as all the centralists, by the way, we hear it from both sides. We see it in both sides. Yes, there are extremists on the right and there are extremists on the left. Guess which one gets into the public media more often? I'm going to tell you something right now. It's both. And the thing is, both sides either need to shut up and listen to the other side, or just shut up and never speak to the other side again. That's it. That is all I'm going to say for now, probably for the rest of this month. Until next time, this is Tiki Bomber signing out. Peace.